This video covers the names of the ZFC's parts, basic photography and playback, and how to use core camera controls. First, let's look at what the parts of the camera are called. These controls are on the top. These controls are found on the front of the camera. These controls are found on the back of the camera. These controls are found on the side of the camera. Now, let's take a look at basic photography and playback. Let's try taking a photograph in auto mode. Using auto mode offers a simple way of taking photographs. Turn the camera on. Select Photo Mode with the Photo Video Selector. Next, choose a shooting mode using the Mode Selector. In this case, we'll choose Auto. Auto Mode puts the camera in charge of shutter speed, aperture, and ISO sensitivity. Frame the shot with your subject in the AF area brackets. Lightly press the shutter release button to focus, and then press the button further down to shoot. Press the playback button to view the picture you just took in the monitor or viewfinder. Press the Playback Zoom In button to zoom the picture in. While the picture is zoomed in, you can press the Playback Zoom Out, Thumbnail, Help button to zoom out. If you want to delete the current picture, press the Delete button. A confirmation dialog will be displayed. Press the Delete button again to delete the current picture. Next, we'll introduce the main camera controls, the control panel, and the monitor. We'll show you how to use these six items. First, the shutter speed dial. Modes S and M let you choose the shutter speed yourself. Rotate the shutter speed dial to choose a shutter speed. Fast shutter speeds freeze motion, while slow shutter speeds suggest motion by blurring moving objects. To choose these settings, you'll need to hold the shutter speed dial lock release while rotating the dial. When 1/3 step is selected, the shutter speed can be adjusted by rotating the main command dial. Next, let's take a look at the ISO sensitivity dial. ISO sensitivity can be adjusted in modes P, S, A, and M. choose an ISO sensitivity, hold the ISO sensitivity dial lock release, and rotate the ISO sensitivity dial. High values allow faster shutter speeds that can be effective when lighting is poor or your subject is in motion. Choose lower values if you notice that your pictures are affected by image artifacts, noise. Now to the exposure compensation dial. Exposure compensation can be adjusted in all modes except M. The exposure compensation dial is used to deliberately alter exposure from the value suggested by the camera. Higher values make the subject appear brighter. Lower values make it darker. Selecting C lets you adjust exposure compensation by rotating a command dial. Exposure can be varied by plus minus 5 EV in photo mode and by plus minus 3 EV in video mode. Now let's find out what the control panel is for. The control panel shows the aperture. In modes A and M, it shows you the value chosen by rotating the subcommand dial. Next stop, the monitor. The monitor supports touch controls that can be used for such tasks as releasing the shutter. You can change the monitor's facing and angle, as you see here. For most shots, the monitor can be positioned against the camera body, facing out. But you may find it useful to tilt it up for low-angle shots and down for high-angle shots. Rotating the monitor so that it faces the subject automatically selects self-portrait mode. In self-portrait mode, you can set the self-timer and choose the number of shots while viewing the monitor. Our last stop is the I button. Pressing the I button displays the I menu, which gives you quick access to frequently used functions. Highlight the desired item and press OK to view options. Highlight the desired option and select it to change the setting and return to the I menu. Take photography to the next level with the ZFC's many features.